Once upon a time, there lived near a large wood a poor family of two children and a stepmother, a little boy called Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They had little enough to break or bite. And once, when there was a great famine in the land, they could not procure even their daily bread. And as the stepmother lay thinking in the bed one evening, rolling about for trouble, she sighed and said, "What will become of us? How can I feed the children when I have no more than I can feed myself? I know, I will lead them away quite early in the morning into the thickest part of the wood, and there I will give them each a piece of bread. Then I will go to work and leave them alone, so they will not find the way home again." The two children, however, had not gone to sleep for very hunger, and so they overheard what the stepmother said. Next morning, before the sun arose, the stepmother went and awoke the two children. Then she gave them each a piece of bread, but in reality, Hansel was not looking at a cat, but every time he stopped, he dropped a pebble out of his pocket upon the path. When they came to the middle of the forest, they were told by their stepmother to collect wood. Their stepmother said, "Now you children, lie down near the fire and rest yourself."
It was now the third morning since they had left their father's house, and they still walked on, but they only got deeper and deeper into the wood, and Hansel saw if help did not come very soon, they would die of hunger. It soon stopped, and spreading its wings, flew off, and they followed it until it arrived at a cottage, upon the roof of which it perched. And they went close up to it. They saw that the cottage was made of bread and cakes, and the window panes were of clear sugar.
Then a sweet voice called in the room, "Tip tap, tip tap, who raps at my door?" And the children answered. Hansel thought the room tasted very nice, so he tore off a great piece, while Gretel broke a large round pane out of the window and sat down quite contentedly. Just then, the door opened and a very old woman walking upon crutches came out. Hansel and Gretel were so frightened that they let fall what they had in their hands, but the old woman nodding her head and said,
"Ah, you dear children, what has you brought you here? Come in and stop with me, and no harm shall befall you."
And so saying, she took them both by the hand and led them into her cottage. A good meal of milk, pancakes with sugars, apples and nuts was spread on the table, and in the bedroom were two nice little beds covered with whites, where Hansel and Gretel laid themselves down and thought themselves in heaven. The old woman behaved very kindly to them, but in reality, she was a wicked witch who captured children and built the bread house in order to entice them in, but as soon as they were in her power, she killed them, cooked them, and ate them, and made a great festival of the day. Witches have red eyes and cannot see very far, but they have a fine sense of smelling like wild bees, so that they know when children approach them. When Hansel and Gretel came near the witch house, she laughed wickedly, saying,
"Here comes two who shall not escape me."
Then she took up Hansel with her rough hand and shut him up in a little cage with a lattice door, and although he screamed loudly, it was of no use. Gretel came next, and shaking her till she awoke, the witch said,
"Get up, you lazy thing, and fetch some water to cook something good for your brother, who must remain in the stall and get fat. When he is fat enough, I shall eat him.
Greta begins to cry, but it was all useless, for the old witch made her do as she wished. Every morning, the old witch came to the cage and said,
"Hansel, stretch your finger that I may feel you whenever you're getting fat."
But Hansel used to stretch out a bones, and this old woman, having very bad sight, thought it was his finger, and wondered very much that he did not get fatter. When 4 weeks had passed and Hansel still kept quite lean, she lost her patience and would not wait any longer.
"Gretel!"
she called out in patience. So early in the morning, Gretel was forced to go out and make a fire. And so saying, she pushed poor Gretel out to the oven, out of the which the flame were burning fiercely.
"Creep in,"
said the witch,
"and see if it's hot enough,"
said she.
"The opening is big enough. See, I could even get in myself."
And she got up and put her head into the oven. Then Gretel gave her a push so that she fell right in, and then shutting the iron door, she bolted in.
Where in every corner were caskets full of pearls and precious stones. So the duck came to them, and Hansel set himself on. And when both were happily arrived on the other side, and had gone a little way, they came to a well-known wood, which they knew the better the each step they went. And at last they saw their father's house, and the pearls and precious stones rolled out upon the floor. And Hansel threw down one handful after the other out of his pocket. Then all their sorrows were ended, and they lived together in great happiness.